Hi, I'm Caitlin.
And I'm Quinn.
We're with the Learning Technology Center. Today, I'm going to show you a general overview of the Desire2Learn homepage.
And then I will take you into a more specific course.
So let's take a look. The first thing we're going to take a look at is how to access your courses. Now, there's two ways to access your courses in D2L. The first way is this top bar right here. This drop-down menu will give you a list of your courses, and then you can pin your courses. And when you pin the course, it'll be at the very top of the list. Now, you can also access your courses on this courses widget down here. Right above the courses widget is the news widget, which will display all the general D2L news items. So we can take a look at the settings, top corner right here. This will give you a drop-down menu with all the settings, and this is also where you log out. Now, if we take a look at the notification settings, you can have any of these news items that are displayed on your D2L page be sent to your email. Now, you can just change your email, and you can either choose to have it sent to your university email, which is what it's defaulted at, or you can choose a different email. So right next to the settings is your alerts. Now, this will alert you to any upcoming quizzes or if anyone has posted to a discussion you're subscribed to. Now, another thing to keep in mind is student resources. If you're having any issues with D2L, you can look at any of these resources, which will provide you, you know, various help. And if you're still having problems, you can contact D2L support. You can also access the resources on the nav bar by clicking for students. Now let's take a look at the tools, which is also on the nav bar. All these tools are general tools that are used in D2L, but that are not course specific. So they include the calendar, email, ePortfolio, and self-registration. So let's pass it off to Quinn, who will give you a more in-depth look into courses.
This is the home page for your D2L course. And you'll see a number of similarities between this and your main home page. First of which is the news box right here. Here you'll see various updates and information provided not for D2L as a whole, but instead for your specific course by your instructor. Now right to the right of that, you'll see a box called the Content Browser. And this allows you to quickly jump between various pieces of content uploaded by your instructor. If you look right below that, you can see a number of links to resources provided by our library. Now last, we can jump up here and see a number of links to the various parts of the D2L course. Here we can see links to things such as a link back to the course home, a link to the content section, to the Dropbox, to the discussion board, to quizzes, to grades, and under more tools, the chat, class list, groups, links, and surveys. For more in-depth analysis of these and more features, check out the rest of our videos.